trivial with going through. Those are hemophilia and colorblindness. Hemophilia is also known as Bleeder's disease. And in Bleeder's disease, you know that blood fails to clot. Even minor injury can become a major one. Colorblindness is that disease in which the individual is not able to distinguish between the colors. Now, these diseases are located, both of them are going. Am I clear? You have understood the difference between carrier and sufferer? Say yes if you have. One of the chromosome bears the gene of colorblindness, while other one is dominant. Wait. Questions. tiger's non-roller of the tongue. Imagine again, go back, two principal, one vice principal, and two vice principal. Okay, so recessive, when mother is roller, then roller gene, dominant gene will be able to express. If you write, both the condition, the child will be able to roll the tongue. This is the correct way of writing, this is incorrect way of writing. Dominant genes are always written first, followed by recessive gene. This is right method. This is incorrect method. Clear? Is it clear? It is not better roller or less good roller. It will be roller or non-roller. There is no average rolling of the tongue. I have given you example there, two examples. One I am repeating. These are two heterozygous roller of the tongue. These are parents. Parental generation. Now we are not taking X and Y here because the genes are located on autosome. So we are taking only, we will not find out who are male and who are female here. We will just speak about the rolling of the tongue. So let us see here, capital R, small r, capital R, small r. These are parents. Okay? Now the gametes produced by them will be capital R, small r, capital R, small r. Now when you make Punnett square here, capital R, small r here, male gamete. Capital R, small r here, female gamete. Okay? So, see the combination here. R, R. Two capital R will come in first offspring. One capital R and one small r will come in the second. Again, one capital R and one small r will come here. Conventionally, good, good. I have written dominant gene first and followed by the recessive gene, and here two recessive genes. Now if you see phenotype, phenotype is physical expression of the gene. This is also roller, this is also roller, this is also roller. This one.
Bio.
Where I have put the dot, these three are roller. Okay? So ratio, phenotypic ratio will be 3 is to 1. 3 roller and 1 non-roller. But when we come to genotype, this is homozygous roller of the tongue. We have written 1. These two are heterozygous roller of the tongue. We have written 2. And child is. One of the child is non-roller. So a heterozygous father can give rise to non-roller, provided mother is also heterozygous roller. Roller and homozygous, non-roller. I hope you have done it, understood it also. Now we'll be starting with Mendel's law of inheritance. Mendel's law of inheritance. Mendel gave three laws of inheritance, and all the three laws are very important from exam point of view. Okay, you have to learn the definition as it is given in the book. It is given in the book, and I have also given in the notes. You are going to learn them as it is. If both of them are homozygous roller, every child will be roller, that too homozygous roller. Now we'll be starting with Mendel's law of inheritance. Listen carefully. Mendel is known as father of genetics. He discovered laws of inheritance or principle of genetics. He worked on pisum sativum. You have to learn this. This is important for 1 mark question. Put an asterisk mark in this line. He worked on pisum sativum, that is garden pea. You have to write botanical name. When you write botanical name, generic name will be in capital, underline, and sativum, that is species, will be in small, and you will underline both of them separately. Okay, so the experimental material for Mendel was pisum sativum. This is an important question of council. Make an asterisk mark there. Now, why did he choose pisum sativum? The choice of pisum sativum was because of its annual nature. Pisum sativum could finish its life cycle in just 1 year. Therefore, he was able to study several generations within a short period of time. Pea plant has a number of easily detectable contrasting characters. Binomial nomenclature, either you write in italics. If you write in italics, you don't combination, that is two hybrids, when crossed together. Now, this two hybrid become parental generation. Okay, that was P1, pure parent. This has become P2, hybrid. The two hybrids are crossed together and then you get one homozygous stall, two heterozygous stall, and one homozygous dwarf. Phenotypically, you are getting three tall and one dwarf. Genotypically, you are getting 1:2, 2:1. Okay? 1:2, 2:1. This law is called as law of segregation.
Understood?
capital R, two small r, will be first parental generation. When the gamete will be formed, there will be haploid condition. Out of 2y, one will come in one gamete, 1y will come in other gamete. Similarly, 1r will come in one gamete, the other r will go in another. Here, one small y will come in one gamete, the other y will come in this gamete. One small r goes in one gamete, the other goes in the other gamete. So, when you get first generation or F1 generation, these two gamete here. So, there will be capital Y small r. All the four will be same. Now this will become a dihybrid. When capital T and small t came together, it was a monohybrid. When these two will come together, it will be a dihybrid. Okay. Now second parental generation will be from the offspring of first generation, F1 generation. Now you have to understand the type of gametes formed. Here, capital Y, small r. Here, capital Y, small r. Small y, capital R. And small y, small r. Same gamete will be formed here also. All right. Now you try to make double, please. You try to make in a rough notebook these four gametes without looking in your notebook. And the moment you have made, you just make sure that one for color and one for shape goes in one gamete. Then you will never be wrong. As you have done, you say yes. All four gametes should be different and should have both the character. Both Devansh. Can you type me the gamete without looking in? Only two have done.